Yes. So let's start our timer. Let's go. It's going to be no name cloudy. All right, that means I get to leave it at float. We're on the clock and we're off. Okay, line 160. Line length 100, and I'm going to leave it at float for cloudy. If we get to midday, that's when I can change it to middle. Again, I don't know if that stat actually works in this game. That's one of the things, one of the many things that that we need to test. One of the many things that needs to be tested in this game. Also, how can we not make this game lag so much that it lags? And some of this I know is my emulator lagging. Some of this I know is my emulator lagging, so my times would not reflect what an NES run would be. Because this game is quite laggy on the NES. But it has been a little while since I've played it on the NES, so I'm not sure just exactly how much more laggy it is when I'm playing it on an emulator and also on stream. Because I have quite an underpowered machine that's trying to stream and run the emulator of a laggy game. Man, I'm getting bad luck so far this run. If this was a real serious attempt, I'd be hitting reset right about now. There we go. Alright. Alright, this fish is well hooked, so I'm going to try and get the sweat drops on him like I did with that first fish before I started the actual run. I'm kind of thinking that I want to get out of day one. Alright, cool. I got some bonus exhaustion from the fish. Oh, and there's the reeling out quickly. But the fish is still exhausted. I still get that bonus exhaustion, which is nice. And my partner Sonic, who 2008, also found that. Now, it's nice having the line at 160 pounds because that lets me reel as long as I've been reeling. And not have to waste my vitality pulling back. Alright, so this should just about bring him in. Can we actually get there on this pull, though? 2, 1, yes. We'll get him on this pull. So every third fish, I'm going to get a level up on body strength. Wow, the 300-pound Cuda, that's exactly what I had on the first little practice run I had there. Interesting. Interesting. I'm missing my Sorry I'm Dead, Megumi My Love layout. I'm going to try to get my splits to work with that on the layout, but I didn't want to mess with that any longer than I already had today to try to get that to work on my streaming window. Because I would like to get Sorry I'm Dead and Megumi My Love on my stream setting. Yeah, that's very strange. I wonder if I need to get that. Oops. Oh, I'm screwing my menuing up. This has become a let's play. It's no longer a timed attempt. I'm getting bad bite luck. And according to the manual, again, who knows how much you can trust the manual. Trying out some strats that Sonicu describes to me. Some holding A while tapping the down button to start the pullback. Because catching these first few scrub fish, and I wish I could get some 100 or 200 pound scrub fish to start. Okay, so that was a barracuda, so that was bad luck. Nothing I could do about that one. It looks like that would have been probably another 300 pounder. Now those will help me for my muscle power stat. But the larger fish don't help you for your body strength stats. Sad. And you know what? I hope that, and it hasn't reared its ugly head yet, I hope that my cheat isn't still activated from when I was testing. Yes, I did pull up that fish behind the seagulls. Let's see if I can... There we go. Alright, so he's well hooked, so let's see if I can get a sweat mark or two on him. Before the line starts to pull out, or before I get too tired. Depends on the size of the fish. Alright, bonus exhaustion. That's nice. That's nice. And this could actually be a day winner. If it's big enough, it could be the day winner. But I do want to, Alright, there he is. I do want to get my, I think at least my muscle power to C before I head on to the next day. 200 sailfish. Alright, that's not going to be enough, so I'm actually not going to keep him, because that will save time on weighing in. The fish will still count towards my level up totals, though. Next fish I catch, I'll get a vitality stat up, level up. It'll be, it's called, body strength in this game. Which, this is terribly translated, name for that stat. But it's called body strength, and it's basically your vitality, your endurance stat. Game's gonna get really laggy now that I have three schools on screen with me. And getting that vitality boost will make a big difference in this game for me. Getting the vitality boost will be huge. It'll let me not slow down when I get down to six or seven. Well, I'll still slow down when I get down there, but getting that bonus endurance really helps. All right. So this will get me my first level up of the day. Yep, and I'm waiting for the little level up fanfare. That was 200. Okay, so I've gotten a 300 and two 200s. I'll get a stat level up in my muscle power at 2,100 pounds of fish. Oops. Yeah, and it's frustrating when you have a school that goes back by the your dock that you started. I don't know if I'm going to be able to turn this shark. Let's see if I can get him in. It's probably a decent size. So that will help me get my muscle power stat up a little bit more quickly. If I can get a sweat drop or two on him. Nice. There's the bonus exhaustion on the shark. Let's hope he doesn't bite off the line, because they can do that. And this is great. Already we're off to a pretty good start. Gotten some bad bite luck, but a lot of this game is going to be luck-based. 500-pound shark. I'm not going to keep him, but that's 500 pounds closer to my stat up. So I'm going to try to get some more billfish now. I'm going to try to start raising them behind the schools of schlubfish, because getting that 500 pounds really helps. So hopefully I catch the winning marlin on the same, and on that winning marlin, or billfish, I get the muscle power stat level up to C, and then that would be kind of the ideal end to day one, if you can get that to happen. And again, this fish I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to get in, because he's not hooked very well. There's his first jump. Saniku was working on a strategy to tap the A button to get fish in without pulling out the hook too much. But this one's big enough that it's getting close to breaking my line. So we'll see if I can get... Yeah, and I'm not going to be able, I don't think... With my stats where they are, I don't think I'm going to be able to outpace his jumping. I've got enough vitality, but without the muscle power stat to bring that in, I don't think I'm going to be able to outpace his jumping. So for time, I'm just going to dump that fish. Because I only really need about a 300 or 400-pound fish, because I saw that the winning fish... On day one, I've seen it go as low as 306, which I had never seen before. I'd always seen it between 350 and 450. Now this fish is going to be fine, and this might just be a 200 pounder though. This might just be a 200 pounder because I can move him pretty well, and he's not putting tons of strain on my line. Got to get him in now that he's under 30. I don't want the QTE events. Excellent. Okay, so that's another 200-pounder. Next fish, I should get another vitality level up. 200 pounds not going to be enough to win the day, so I'm not going to keep them, because any fish you keep, when you weigh in, you have to watch the fish weighing animation. So I want the only fish that I keep to be the day winner, so that I only have to watch the fish weighing animation once, if we're going for a good time, which I am. Although, the lower my time is today, the easier it will be to beat that time later on. So, there you have it. Once your stats are leveled up, you really see the difference quickly, especially once you get a muscle power stat up. You're finding it becomes very easy to reel in bigger fish, which helps you get the next muscle power stat level up, because strangely, that happens at 4,200. So it's just another 2,100 pounds of fish to get to the next stat level up in that category. I'm going to bounce back to float now that I'm going for billfish. I'm going to go with the manual, although I've learned the manual cannot always be trusted. And probably more not trusted than trusted would be my guess. And I'm keeping the lure just at feather. Lure choice does seem to make some difference, but I do not have any idea how the game tracks what fish, if any, is behind a school or willing to come up from behind a school, and how to best draw them. Now, the manual does have some really campy descriptions of different kinds of the billfish prefer different lures. But I've caught all of the billfish on all of the lures. So as far as preferences go, so this one was a little bit tough to pull back on, so this is a pretty good size fish. Alright, so there's my bonus exhaustion, because he was hooked well, so I got good luck on the hooking there. Alright, let's see if I can get him in from 30. Nice. Alright, so this one should give me, if I'm counting right, my next vitality stat level up. And that'll also be the day winner. Body strength B. Alright, so that'll be my day winner, and I'm just going to catch some scrub fish until I get to... And I don't know if I'm going to be able to move this shark. It might not be worth pulling in, although if I can move him and get him in fairly quickly, he'll be a nice chunk towards my next, towards my muscle power level up. If I can get him in. And it looks like I'm able to move him. Because yes, contrary to what the manual kinda says, you do get experience from sharks. Both muscle power and body strength experience. By strength and endurance levels. Alright. So if I can get my muscle power stat up, I'm gonna head over to weigh-in. Okay, muscle power is C. We're done. I'm going to go off to the weigh-in, and I'm going to hit my split when my winning fish sprite comes up on the screen. Or it's my winning character sprite, I should say. Got to execute my dock landing. There we go. Sometimes it can be a little finicky. So I do have to weigh this fish. And so had I kept any of those other smaller marlin, 401. Alright, so this should be it. That's me. There's my split. Alright. Cloudy here also, and I want to be in Kailua. You know what? I forgot to write down what venues I want to be in the other two Hawaii days. Now it does... Oops. 160. 100. Alright, yeah, so the game does, or I did write down which ones are the most open layouts, because that's really the ones you want. That's why I'm in Kailua. That's why I chose Palm Beach on the first day, because you want levels of the most open layouts. As the game goes on, the actual level layouts get a little more tricky to navigate. There's lots of obstacles you have to drive around. They're quite annoying. There we go. Let's see about this one. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's where I wanted my drag. I was unsure about my drag. I messed up my drag execution there. That was poor. That was poor, Corey. All right, we got him though. That muscle power level up really helps me a lot here. And I've been doing too many pullbacks. I'm trying to horse him in too quickly. I'm losing hookage. I should put in the FAQ about the hook status. I think that's important to know, and it's hard to explain, but I can put that down in the channel description. You know what? I'm gonna see if that fish will win today. I might just YOLO it with this fish. Because the only penalty is I would just have to start the day over. That'd be the only penalty, is that I have to start the day over if it's not big enough. 494. Not me. So 5 was not enough. Not by much, though. Alright, so I'll shoot for a 600. So that's another thing to keep in mind, is you don't really lose all that much time. If this was a real, you know, PB attempt, I probably would reset, especially since I'm only 15 minutes in. But this really isn't a PB attempt, this is just a splits gathering attempt. So, not all that much time lost. Really just, it's an extra fish weighing, and then you have to watch the animation of your opponent's fish weight ticking up with your opponent's sprite. But had that been me, so I'm looking for about a 600 pounder, huh? Will be my silver tuna, and you can catch tuna in this game. There are tuna here available. For catching. Alright. And there's another bouncing school. Not going at the angle I like, but that's okay. So normally what I would do on a casual playthrough is I would just follow that first bouncing school, and I would just keep changing baits and depths until something popped up. But for speed purposes, I am not sure if that's what I want to do. Oops, I motored through them. I'm not sure if that's the best way to preserve it until we know more about how lure choice and depth affect fish appearance and or fish bite chances. And also things like weather and sun, which are supposed to have an effect on what's happening. But we don't really know. I don't know. Hoping to find that out, but we'll need to have some ROM hacking, I think. To get that kind of data, we may need to get into the ROM. I don't know if that's the kind of data we can gather easily just with playing the game, even using save states and Game Genie codes, which is how we've gathered what we know so far, is save states and Game Genie codes. I motored over the whale. I am getting bad spawns, bad fish spawns today here in Kailua. Getting very bad fish spawns. And yes, I forgot to write down which are the best day 3 spots and 4. I think I remember the day 4 spot is the one to the right. And I'm really just getting bad luck with the billfish spawning. Been driving this boat around for a few minutes with nothing. And here's where knowledge of how lures, there we go, affect things would be really helpful. All right, he's well hooked. So let's see if we can tire him out. Alright, the hook's starting to come out. Alright, but I'm able to move him pretty well. So I have gotten some exhaustion on the fish. Not enough for a sweat mark level. But probably soon he'll get a sweat mark. By the time I get him in, we may see one. Or we may not. That's okay. Let's see if I can get him in without a QTE. Got him. Alright, so I'm looking for 600 to win this day. Okay, body strength is up. Good, and I may be close to another muscle power stat up also. Because I've caught a couple of 500-pounders, although maybe that's all I've caught. So maybe I do have a little ways to go. All right, let's see if we can get this guy. All right, he was not hooked as well as his compatriots even. But he may... There we go. So that first jump is always... always got to remember it's coming. That first jump. And then you've got to try to outpace what they can do with their jumps. The next jump comes a little bit longer after the time from first hooking to first jump. And we're in without another QTE. Very good, very good. That's what we want. Okay, another 500. Not going to want that one. Otherwise, you're going to have to... If you're going for 500, you're going to have to hope to get good RNG on a fish. Ooh, this is a big one. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get this one in. Let's see if I can get a... If he's well hooked, I can get a sweat bead on him. He's not as well hooked. And even with what exhaustion I have gotten on him, I can't move him. So really, without getting a bonus go for it, I'm not going to be able to move him. This is a big, big, big fish. Because there are 900 and 1,000... Oh, there's one sweat drop. But even with that, I'm not able to move him very much. I was able to get just one sweat drop on him. And I've lost it. By easing up on him, I've lost the sweat drop. So his recovery rate is quite fast. Yeah, I'm not going to get this fish in. Because I have a feeling the speed game on this is going to involve catching the smallest fish you can get away with on any given day, is going to be my guess. The speed game is going to be smallest fish that you can get away with. So I'm going to be aiming for that 600-pounder today. And I need to do some testing to see what the actual range is, because I used to think that day one, it was between 350 and 450, but then I saw that 306 one the other day. So must be a very small chance for it to be smaller than that. So this day might have a wider range than I thought as well. All right, so this one's a little smaller. I can move it. Not hooked as well though, unfortunately. There's the first jump. I'm gonna need to get some exhaustion on the fish. That horrible beeping, I'm sorry, is going to continue. Doing my best. Because what I really need to do is hook a 600-pounder and just get that one in. Either that, or possibly I need to level up. I'm still kind of planning the route. Yeah, that was unfortunate. Because sometimes whenever you raise a marlin behind a school of fish, it usually doesn't hit right away. Usually it will take a few seconds before it'll hit. Now sometimes they will bite almost on the same frame that they appear, so you actually won't even get a chance to see the little marlin sprite pop up. But usually it's a few seconds after you raise a marlin behind the school that it will bite. And that can happen. If you raise it and the school is close to a wall and it's not a bouncing school, the school will scatter and the marlin will scatter with them, which is unfortunate. I think this is a bouncing school, yes. And they the schools in this game bounce off kind of at cue ball angles. It's kind of how they bounce off like pool balls on a pool table cushion. They bounce off at the same angle they came in. So this one's not hooked very well, but I can move him much more easily than the other ones. Because he was hooked, when I first got him, he was right on the edge of level 1 and level 2 crisis level of hook. So like level 0 crisis is when the line's not moving at all. Level 1 crisis is where it is right now. And he's kind of drifting right on the edge of level 1 and level 2 crisis. Hook crisis. Maybe this will be my 600 pounder. And I can call it a day. Alright. That was unfortunately timed. Alright. See if I can get him in without a QTE here. Alright. Got him in. $400. No dice, huh? Fine, that's 400 closer to the next muscle power stat up. So that might be something in the speed game for the player to have to kind of count, because I've gotten a 500, a 500, 400. Has there been another 500? That's another thing that the speed gamer is going to have to count to know how close you are to a level up, because if I'm close to another muscle power level up, I might just try to hook one of the scrub fish. Ooh, good, I get an instant bonus, but that must mean this fish is very small. I can reel him in on one pull. Oh, okay. At least it's bigger than the 200. All right, what are we looking at? Okay, body strength, double A. Not as helpful as... There's muscle power B. Okay, cool. This fish is not going to be keepable. It was only 300, I think. But I got the muscle power up to level B. So we're set on muscle power for this level. And then body strength is maxed out at double A. So I don't, it doesn't matter how many fish I catch anymore. That was the 12th fish that I've caught in this run through then. Because 12 fish gets you up to body strength double A. Muscle power takes a lot longer. Because it goes by poundage of fish that you're catching. But now that I'm leveled up, the next one of those bigger marlins that I hook, I should be able to handle much more easily. So here's one, let's see if I can hook him. Alright, let's see if he's... Now, and this one also is huge for me, so this could be one of those 1,000-pounders. Yes, jeez. Come on. Come on. I just want that 600-pounder. And this might be a cut. This is going to be a cut, I think. Because I'm not going for a personal best fish size. I'm just going for fish I can land and have it be in the 600 range. Oh, that one's already got a billfish behind it. I think that's how you're supposed to discover that that's what you need to do in this game. I think you're supposed to randomly see a marlin behind a school sometime, because they do sometimes appear without you drifting a lure behind a school. They will sometimes randomly pop up like that. Ooh, this is dangerous. I'm stopping with him under 30. That was dangerous. That was a dangerous fight, but this one's still probably not going to be big enough. Ah, no. I might regret throwing all these 500-pounders away, because it may be that one of them will win, but... Maybe I should have kept that one and took it to the dock with me. Not like I would have lost much time. Ooh. If all junk fish will do for me now is just add poundage to my muscle power stat. So had that fish that I caught that gave me the muscle power and the body strength stat up been of the winning variety, that would have been the best luck I could hope for speed game purposes. There we go. Get him in. But I have a feeling this one's gonna be smaller, too. I should maybe have kept that last 500 pounder and seen if it was gonna, see if it was gonna be clutch for me. This kick is the fish that I'm catching here are gonna help me get my muscle power up to that, to the A and double A deck, because it takes 2100 for each level, the first two levels, and then weirdly it takes 2200 after that. Weirdly it takes 2200 for the next level, so it's at 21, 42, and 64. And then the next one, the top level, is at 90-something, 91 or 9200 maybe. Still some testing to do with that. The first jump's coming soon. There it is. All right. And even after the first jump, I've still got a few feet on him. That's a good indicator. And so this one's a little heavier. This might be my day winner. This might be that 600, because I'm able to move him. But not easily. Alright, here we go. And I lost him. There's the QTE. That's the QTE. That's the skill level thing in this game. That's one of the most maddening things about this game. Are those QTEs. And that may have been my day winner right there. And all lost for the bad RNG that I got the QTE and then I did not hit A on the correct frame. This one looks like it may be about the same size. So, let's hope I can get this one in without a troll QTE screwing my thing up. Gonna be a lot of line clinking, unfortunately, because this fish is on the bigger end, but I'm able to move it. And it's not hooked well enough for me to, on now. We've got plenty of vitality. I've got enough strength to keep me going. The problem is, without good luck on another QTE, because you can get QTEs when the fish is farther out, where you can tire them out, that are a little bit less trolly than the propeller one. I don't think I'm going to get this fish in. So I don't think I'm going to get this one in. Yep. Because without being able to move him a little bit faster, I wasn't going to be able to outpace his jumping. And then fish exhaustion is another stat we need to look up. So those fish are going right for the dock, so I can't follow them towards the dock, or I'll get that menu asking me if I want to go back to the dock. I don't need to go back to the dock. I have a feeling that fish that I lost in the QTE was going to be my day winner. That was going to be my day winner. That's my best guess. See again, this one's not hooked very well either. But I'm able to move him okay. Alright, yes, I'm outpacing. Alright, I need to back up because I gotta get him in from 30 quickly. to reduce QTE chances. Alright, let's see if this is going to be my day winner. Let's do it. There it is. 600. Right to the dock, baby. Right to the dock, baby. And that 600 is going to be 600 more for the level up bank. I wish it didn't lag so much. Whenever there's fish on the screen is when the lag happens. So those schools of fish, the game really has a difficult time with those schools of fish. It just lags a lot. 632. Alright, that's me. Let's do it. Alright, cloudy. I think this is the open one that I want. Yes, this is the open one that I want. Kauna Kakai. Alright, and it's still cloudy, so I'm going to keep it afloat. Alright. We're going right after the billfish now. Done leveling up on the junkfish. So we're going right for the billfish. So yes, it is this music again. All right. Let's do this. Let's do this. This one I think is going to be too small. So if this was a real speed game, or if I had already maxed out my levels, I would just cut this one. But I'm going to go ahead and get him because I do still have a little bit of leveling to do. I still have 2 muscle power levels I can earn. And in a speed game, probably I'm not going to max out muscle power in a speed game because I don't think it's necessary. Because to catch the 800 or so pounders, I probably could do that with the stats I have now. With a lucky hook. Could probably do that, or with a lucky go for it, because you can get those little bonus go for it sometimes. But I am not sure. I need to. That's what we're measuring here. All right, this one's well hooked. There's a nice go for it, and a fish that's a pretty good size. So let's see if this can be my day winner. 600. Okay. I don't think 600 is going to be enough, but I got my muscle power up to A. I'm going to shoot for a 700, although I might be shooting too far. But, yes, because I still have yet to do testing on exactly how big a fish you need in this one. But I did get that muscle power up, so I'm almost max level now. Muscle power A. So let's see if I can get it to... I hope I finish this game before I level up to double A, but that might not happen. That's okay if it doesn't. Because you can get little lucky go-for-its like that on fish that are kind of out of your size category. Because there are, believe it or not, in the very first day of this game, I found, using the Game Genie code, you can get 900 and 1,000 pound marlin on that first day. You can hook them. You'll never catch them at level D. But you can get, I believe, some of those lucky go-for-its. Now this one might be too big for me. Even at level A to get in, because there are 1,000 and 1,200 pound fish around here in this game. So yeah, with my line and what I have, I'm not enough to bring that guy in, because that might be one of those 1,000 pounders. And without a lucky go for it prompt. And when I say go for it prompt, what I'm talking about, I'm usually probably skipping those faster than you can see them or read them if you're not familiar with this game. Is sometimes you get these little bonus things that say go for it, the fish is very exhausted, and you'll get a big bonus on the exhaustion level of the fish. That's something also that we need to learn, if that's manipulatable at all. If we can make that happen in our favor. Right now, it's just random, but we don't know if there are actions that you can take as the player to influence that. Oh my. I forgot to turn my drag down. That was a mistake, because this is a pretty decent fish. So I lost a bunch of line by not turning my drag down. Trying a tap technique that Sonic Who taught me. But I may have just totally botched this fish from the get-go by not setting my drag down. And just mute me if the beeping is too much for you. I wish that wasn't a sound cue, but it is. Oh, I pushed it too hard. Pushed him too hard. I may have just botched that by not putting my drag down. That may have been a botched move by me. Because that fish may have been catchable, but I was trying to horse him too much. Because I can't really afford in this game to get into a 10-plus minute fight with a fish if I'm going for a speed game. It wouldn't be worth it. Even if the fish was the day winner. It's not worth to get into a 10-plus minute fight with the fish because you can always lose him in a QTE. Oh, this is a tuna. First tuna of the speed game of the day. Just for the poundage of weight, I'm going to catch him. Normally, if I'd maxed out levels, I would turn him loose. Ooh, and at 200 probably would have just been worth turning him loose. Yes, tuna will sometimes pop up where billfish should be, and they even use the same billfish sprite. So that's just what you have to deal with. It's just something you have to live with in this game. It's meant to be kind of a troll. Troll fish, I guess. And they can be, I suppose. They can be trolly. I'm trolling right now, by the way. Trolling this bait. I don't know if I've hooked a fish behind a whale yet today. Again, lots to learn about this game. Lots and lots to learn. And we really need some help from the ROM hacking community, if anyone's knowledgeable or available. Alright, this fish I can move. I can move it a little bit too well, though, so it's probably not going to be that 700-pounder I'm looking for. Nope. But six or so fish like that will get me to my max levels. They will get me to my my double A level. Six or so fish like that gets me to double A. Alright, that is a bouncing school. So we will follow. So I didn't turn up right away to chase them. Because if they are not a bouncing school, this one's going to be too small, I can tell already. But let's get him in. Just because we bothered to bring him up, let's get him in and get the experience points from his weight. But I could tell right away that he wasn't going to be big enough. I wish I hadn't botched it on that other fish. If I was going for real attempts on this, that probably would be. I probably would have reset a couple times if I was going for real PB attempts, but this is just a first-time PB. Okay. Neither of those are bouncing, but as you can see, the level layouts on day 3, this is the most open of the level layout, I believe. I should have written those down before I started, because I did make a note of that the other day, but I can't remember 3 and 4, but this one, I believe, is the most open layout of day 3. And then day 4, I do believe it's the level to the right. But you can see there's a lot more nooks and crannies, even on this one that's the most open plan. There's more nooks and crannies, more obstacles, things that fish can bounce around so that the non-bouncy schools of fish will scatter much more regularly, and bouncy schools will bounce in weird ways. Go. Yes, but this trolling sequence really is lag-tastic. The game really has a hard time, and part of it's my emulator, so presumably if I was playing this on NES, I would have an even better time. That a bouncing school as well? Alright, oops. I motored through them. I did not mean to do that. I meant to turn around and get my bait behind him. I may switch over to this whale. Again, I don't want to experiment too much with lure changing until we know more about that. But we'll have to find fight percent values in the ROM of this game sometime and figure out what our best option is there. I guess also, I'm trying to think of things like optimizing things for speed. You would want to avoid whales or avoid other schools of fish just for lag management purposes. Oh, this one's not hooked well. I can move him, but he's not hooked well. And there's the first jump. Alright, at least I didn't screw my drag up. Alright, here we go. This is my chance to get some bonus exhaustion on the fish. Alright, cool. I get a little bonus exhaustion on the fish by choosing the quote-unquote correct choice in that QTE. So that may be what gets me my my victory on this day, because this may be that 700 that I'm looking for. 800, excellent. Time to turn around, back to camp. Oh good, and I was close to the exit, but I didn't know it. So there's another thing you'd have to, in a speed game, really learn your level layouts and know where you are. Look at that, breaking the platform, breaking the boardwalk. And the guy looking to the right, we gotta come up with names for these people. 805, yep, results for today, that's me, baby. .47-49 is the split. Okay, cool. Still cloudy. Alright. And I do believe it's Nihao. Yes, it is Nihao. Nihao is the most open. Oh, I went the wrong way again. Not saving those frames. So, because we're cloudy, I'm going with floats again. That's what the manual says, but I already know the manual lies about line test strength making a difference. So I'm actually hoping that the manual is lying about different lures being differently effective, and things like the sun and things like the depth. I'm hoping, really hoping, that those are also bugged and not working. I'd rather have that be up to RNG, because that would be more guessing and more managing that I'd rather not do myself. So yes, Nihao is the most open level layout on this third day. And you'll notice on this third day that a lot of the marlin you hook, you really don't have much problem finding marlin. But many of them will be very small. The big ones are rare. So I have kind of found that the best day, if you're going for just catching the biggest fish, is really going to be day three of the tournament. Will be the best day for just catching big fish, because more of the fish are bigger on that day. This day, there are big fish on this last day, and they're probably the biggest fish in the game, although that's not confirmed, that's just a guess. But they're quite rare. There's lots of 300 and 400 pounders on this day. And like this, that's what this guy probably is gonna be. Maybe this one will be a little bit bigger. Alright, another good choice. Oh yeah, so that jump did not count. I was wondering about that. That jump did not count as his first jump. So So a QTE jump does not count as just a planned event jump. All right, muscle power is maxed out. So I am now max levels in this game on this day. So actually, my level progression worked pretty well, I think. Just kind of organically, my level progression worked pretty well. I got a stat up in each one. I guess the only day was that first day where I did a little bit of extra grinding, I think, on day one to get the muscle power, and I think that was worth it. Because that day has lots of smaller fish that you can actually land and earn that experience. But I kind of organically got it. So now if I hook that game winner here, I can still get that sub 1 hour. Because I've got max levels. If I hook that game winner right here, right now, could still go for sub 1 hour. Right now my PB is 2 hours 3 minutes, but that's not really a PB because I took a break and I was screwing around with some things, so I wasn't really attempting to get through the game as quickly as I could, like I am today. All right, here we go. This is the game winner. If I can get him in, I can tell already. I'm gonna probably need a lucky QTE though to move him. This is gonna be my game winner though, if I can get him in. But I think even with my levels where they are now, I'm gonna need a lucky QTE to get this guy in. With between the load on my line and the way he's hooked, you can see it's taking a lot longer for the load on the line to lessen. It might be worth it to keep this fish on though as long as I can to try to get a lucky QTE. I don't think in the speed game it's going to be worth grinding for a skill level up. I really don't think that's going to be worth it in this game. Sonicu did a lot of great work. All right, well, I get the tailwalk choice. Okay, so bad choice on the tailwalk. Could have gotten some exhaustion there. That actually would have been quite nice. I could have gotten some exhaustion on the tailwalk. So, I guess I still think that grinding for a level up in skill is probably not going to be worth it, although it would have helped me here on this one. I lost the hook. That's okay. It would have helped me in that battle to have a little bit higher skill level, but I'm thinking the time required for that would be just too much. One idea he came up with was prompting the propeller one by just keeping a fish within 20 feet and just kind of letting it sit there, just keeping a fish that's small, and then prompting that propeller one so that you are forced to make a bunch of choices and try to choose correctly. But you're going to lose a good... Every time you choose wrong, you're going to... And every time you choose right, you will get credit for it. But 5 QTEs for first level up is pretty rough. That's 5 extra... You could really have to call them extra fish battles, because you wouldn't want to intentionally prompt one on a fish that you thought could be the day winner. You wouldn't want to do that. You wouldn't want to intentionally prompt especially a propeller one, where if you choose incorrectly, you lose the fish. Those ones are bad. Those ones are very bad. See if I can pull up one behind these seagulls quick. This is always... They treat this like a hint in the manual and on the few facts that are out there. It's like a hint. Follow the seagulls. But that's not like a secret. It's in the manual. Oh, look, and there I drew one up, but they went over land. Look at that. After all that work, I procced one, and when they go over land, it treats it like a fish school scattering. So, just disappear. That's why the seagulls are pretty tricky. But without a school of fish to jump right onto, all right, I'm not going to mess with them anymore, though, because they're going too far overland. Here in Nihao, we got seagulls. Alright, well, so long, sub 1 hour, I think, probably. That's not going to happen. Maybe if I had chosen correctly on that tailwalk QTE, I could have gotten that one in, got my sub 1 hour. How's this one? Alright, here's another decent one. This one's decent. But I'm able to move him, so he might not be big enough. I'm able to move him without too much trouble. Let's see. And I shouldn't have... When this one was hooked well, I shouldn't have wasted his hook potential. All right, here's a jump. Here's a jump. All right, lost a chunk of line. That's too bad. Because could have used some bonus... Could have used some bonus exhaustion that time. Ugh, plus we get that jump. Because again, the QTE jumps, as we have learned, do not count as a scheduled fight screen jump. So I'm going to lose this fish, I think, too. Because I wasted a good hooking trying to get the sweat mark, but I think they're too big. That must make a difference. The size of the fish must make a difference on how much hook power runs out of them, and I don't think I'm going to be able to outpace... Yeah, I don't think I'm going to be able to outpace the fish. So again, it came down to a QTE where, had I guessed correctly, I wouldn't have lost the line, and I would have gotten some bonus exhaustion that would have let me probably get that fish in. So that's two fish that could have been... I don't know what the size of that one would have been. Bigger than the... You know, maybe eight? It's hard to guess. I'm not that good yet where I can guess what an 800-pounder feels like at... max levels. But maybe 9? I don't know. And with this day, I think any fish I catch that I think might be big enough, I'm just going to keep it and head back to the dock. Because why not? Ooh, almost got him before the jump. There we go. Almost got him before the jump, but you know what? I should have just cut the line on this one because I know it's not going to be big enough for me. If this was a real speed game, I probably would be doing that. I probably would cut the line. If I can see that I can pull back on the fish easily. And how I won on my last, what I call PB, even though it's not really a PB, it's what I'm going for today as a PB. Because I'm still on the last level, and I'm more than an hour faster than that quote-unquote PB. But on that one, the winning fish I caught was on... I hooked a 900 or so pounder on this last day, and I got a bonus go for it. I got a go for it right away in the battle. So it was a cake. So... This last day when you need a bigger fish might just be, And see, now I probably should cut the line here, but I'm curious. And if I'm trying to beat a time, I'm gonna cut the line. If I have a time to beat, I'm gonna cut it here. But here we're gonna say so long to our sub 1 hour. Although sub 1 hour is certainly possible, which is good to know. It's good to know that this game can be a sub 1 hour game. I'll save these splits, too, for when I do more full game playthroughs. And if I could do my splits without having to navigate away from my emulator window, I would probably put more splits for leveling up on there, instead of just three splits on the end. Game. All right, let's see how this one's going. Yeah. Yeah, this one's going to be tiny. This one's going to be tiny. Should have just cut it there. But I don't think I'm going to cut it on any today. If I have a time to beat, I'll cut the line on some of those fish. But here's a lot more of these just time waster fish. And I don't know if they put a lot of these small ones in here to... I don't think it's to waste your time. I think that maybe they put it in there so that if you are not maxed out on your levels, then a novice casual player could max his or her levels out on this last screen so that they would hook the occasional fish that's just way too big for them, but there would be plenty of smaller marlin on which to level up if they haven't figured out the very arcane leveling system here. Also could be just to kind of confound you, because it does mean that a very small percentage of the fish that you do hook are going to be of get day winning size, whether or not you can bring them in. Because I think I'm going to go for an 800 pounder or so, but there are 1,000+ marlins in this game, so I don't want to be hooking one of those on this last day. I want to catch an 800 pounder, because I have a feeling that I could catch an 800 pounder quickly without too much fuss. Try to keep my bait in a good spot. There we go. And there's the jump. Yep, I shouldn't have leaned back. I've got to learn that timing a little better. Timing of the first jump of almost any billfish you hook. They've got a specific timing. Oh, okay, here we have a line cut on the propeller. All right, and he's gone. Because I really don't want to build in QTE skill grinding in the early stages of this game. That just does not sound like much fun to me. But it may be something I have to test. It may be something I have to test against these splits that I'm creating today. Maybe something I need to test is if I need to grind on QTEs for a level up. But it's just, they really put you behind the eight ball with making it difficult to get QTEs correct when you're not very high level. And they make you have to get 5 of them correct to start to get better at them. So getting the last few levels of QTE is probably a lot easier than getting the first one, which is not how most level up games are supposed to be balanced. You should be able to get that first level up pretty easily. Then it should be more difficult after that. All right, this is a nice one. But again, I'm going to have to hope probably for a QTE to get him, because I can't move him well enough. I can't get enough line in each pull. This might be one of those, because I remember when I was a kid catching them of weight, you know, weights of like 1200 and such. So this one, I have to figure that out, how to get around the, because the trick that Sonicu have, the tapping the down button while holding A, is quite nice. But the line tension is tricky, so I'll have to play around with that some more to see if I can use any of my skill to actually get some of these ones in. Because even at max levels, this fish is not moving very well. And I'm gonna have to rely on a lucky QTE. All right, here's an opportunity. All right, there's some bonus exhaustion, so maybe this is going to be it. Still not enough to actually give him a sweat drop. Oh, and there's the scheduled jump, which is too bad. That really is unfortunate. Because if you get it wrong and lose some line on those. Ugh. Even with that, I'm not able to move him very well. Alright, yep. Even with a successful QTE, I wasn't able to move him. Those are other fights that can go on and on and on and on. They can go on for 20 minutes or half an hour. And I've had those happen, and then I've lost them to the propeller. Because when you can't pull them quickly... when you can't pull them in quickly, they're going to be hanging around your motor for too long. So you're almost always going to get a QTE by your motor if you can't really yank them in from 30 feet out. And so I've had, yes, 20-minute fights. And on a propeller QTE, which is really, really infuriating, but part of the game. Part of the game. But I'm glad I have these split sets. Or I'm glad I'm going to have these split sets today, so that I have some idea of what we need to do. And I'm still way ahead of where I thought it would be. Alright, here we go. There's a nice bonus for me. I don't know if he's going to be big enough, though. I leaned back a little slowly. 600. No. I leaned back a little bit slowly. So I had a little bit of hope there. But not enough. Alright. If they bounce, then we're going to bite, so I had to get my bait out of the way. Oh, this is a tuna, so I am going to cut the line on this one. You can tell right away by the music and by the lack of dorsal fin sticking out of the water. Tell right away by those things. Nothing about these trolling sequences that the sound of the boat motor takes out a channel of music. And as much as I love the music in this game, it's unlucky that you lose a channel of it with the boat motor moving, and you also lose a channel of it when your line is clinking. There's the end. I knew we were getting close to the end. And of course, having two spools on the screen with me really makes the game lag. But only if your boat's also moving. So if you just sit there still, and you have two or three spools on the screen with you, they can run just fine. Oh, plus some seagulls and maybe a whale. One. Not going to be my winner, though. Couldn't quite get him in before the first jump. And again, on a speed game, if I really was trying to cut my time, I would have cut him loose. There we go. Lucky I didn't get a bite there from that school. There certainly was a chance of that, because that can happen. Yep. Even if you're not moving the bait, and they swim under your bait, you're in their bite hitbox, so to speak. Whoa. I skipped some frames there. That was strange. It's going to be another small one, though. So that's something to think about, that maybe I don't need to grind on that first level for that muscle power stat, because there's plenty of opportunity in this last day to grind. Although, I don't know, maybe that would make winning the previous day a little bit harder. I don't know, the fish that I caught yesterday that was 800 pounds, that would be enough to win today. So I want that fish back. Can I use that fish today? Can I use that fish today? Here in beautiful Niihau. Beautiful Niihau, Hawaii. But I'm glad that the most open levels does include all three level musics. The center one, the left one, and the right one. Because here, this is the music that plays on the right-hand level of each day when you turn your wheel to the right to select your location. The center one, of course, is in Palm Beach. And then Kailua, I think, on the second day is to the left. And Kauna Kakai, is that one also in the center? Do we double up on the center? I believe we do. Alright. Don't know what size we're looking at here. Probably pretty small, though, judging by me pulling the fish in one pullback. No. Don't want that one. A little bit bigger, but not one of those 1,200-pound monsters that's going to take me all day to bring in and then probably lose. I don't want that. And I've had a couple of those so far. Okay. They're not going to bounce. Some of the handier bouncing schools are ones that just go straight vertically or straight horizontally so that you can just kind of do this when they bounce. You can just turn your boat around. Oh, get behind them again. Those are some of the handiest ones. The ones that go at an angle, sometimes it's tough to match the angle of the school with your boat. I'm pretty good at matching the angles with the boat. And it just takes a little bit of practice. It's not very hard, but sometimes it's just a little tricky to set up. You gotta get your bait sitting just in the right spot. Ooh, look at that. Look at that. Can I get there before they get to the edge, though? Yes. That was going to be the big question. All right, now this one, I'm able to move him, not too easily, though. He's hooked well. Line's not responding great, so he's decent size at least. If it's 700, I may go for it on this fish. Because I'm not quite sure. Wow. Some of that tension up line. He's going to jump again soon. There he is. Alright. See if I can get... Alright, is this going to be it? Ah, man, come on. Come on now. All right, we gotta jump. We gotta jump. I gotta nail this. Gotta nail this. Let's do it. And then I don't know when his next scheduled jump is. Right now. So he gets to stack that, which is really a punch in the gut in this game, that they get to stack that. The QTE jumps. And their regularly scheduled battle jumps. So maybe I won't beat my previous PB of 2 hours, 3 minutes. Maybe that means I will have to grind for a skill level, but man, I don't want to have to do that. I beat it last week without grinding for a skill level. But I guess I got a lucky go for it on the winning fish on this last day. But maybe you can't... I guess you can't depend on that. Obviously you can't rely on that. Obviously, you can't rely on that. And I lost my hook. Ugh. I had a good initial pull. Maybe I was too impatient, but I had a good great start. Got him in 50 right away. And this one's smaller. This is not going to do it. I had a good initial pull on that one, and then having him stack the QTE jump with a scheduled jump was the killer, because he got about 60 feet on me there. Yeah, the billfish fights, when they go on for a long time, if you're not able to get them in quickly, you're not going to be able to outpace their jumping line. Which is why you do have to work kind of quickly with those fish. Is that because that every so often, they're just going to take 30 or so free feet. They're just going to get 30 or so feet on you for free. Regardless of anything you're doing, any status, you cannot stop it, you can't control it, it's just going to happen. They're just going to take 30 or so feet. So if you can't get 30 or so feet advantage on them between those jumps once they start happening, then the fish is going to ultimately beat you. They're just going to grind your line out, and they're going to beat you like that fish did. But if you get good luck on a QTE, or good skill on a QTE, there we go. Oh, yuck. That can happen. Sometimes you can get really nicely placed. And I've also had it happen too, where a marlin would pop up, and then a school of scrub fish would come over and bite right on top of where my marlin is. And I would hook the scrub fish rather than the marlin, which is, of course, unfortunate. Oh boy, this last level is really killing me. This final split. But I guess the last level should be the longest. It wasn't on my last run through, though. I guess I got a lucky fish. I'm gonna try this school. Oops. Hooked one of the scrubs. This week, I'm not really gonna, very proudly anyway, call any timed playthrough of this game a speed run, because the game is so random. There's a go for it. This might be it. This might be it. Because it was kind of a slow pullback. I had a slow pullback. Let's do it. Let's see. 900, that's it. That's the game, baby. Sub 120, here I come. Sub 120, let's do it. Can we make it? And I'm gonna hit my final split when, I don't know if I'm gonna make sub 120, when my weight is finished counting up on my winning screen is when I'm gonna hit the, oh no, oh I botched it. I thought that the dock was around that first, oh no, I botched this too. I botched my docking. Return to port. Weighing. I don't think I'm going to get sub 120. Come on. Get there. Don't be too big. Because I'm going to have to watch it again. Alright. I'm going to hit it when it hits that spot. Let's do it. New record. 119.45. So I'm gonna call it on that because technically there's two more button pushes I can do. Technically there's two more button pushes I need to do because I have to get the password and listen to the guy saying you have won all tournaments. But because I have to leave navigate away from my emulator and then hit the timer by navigating away, I'm just gonna do it when that hits my top time, and it's gonna be within a second or so if I was mashing. So I'm gonna call it that. Listen to the overture. This isn't the overture. This is the finale. I'm not sure what we're looking at here. I'm looking at this big, pecked man holding a Marlin sprite from one of their jumping sprites. I believe it's a jumping sprite that they use. He's got huge pecs, and he's also standing in the water, it looks like. There we go. That's Fiend. I wonder if that's also a play on Finn.